inspection itself, you can see you have to examine the abdomen tangentially from in this view. On examination from this view, you can see an epigastric mass here. On inspection, it is moving. You can see this lower abdomen is flat, whereas upper abdomen is having a fullness. On inspiration, you can see that is a mass moving with the inspiration. You can very well watch it. If you are unable to see, I'm going to show you the border of the mass. I'm going to make a line. This is the border of the mass. You can see I'm marking the line. This is such a big mass is here. So this is a mass. You can see that mass is moving with the inspiration. So this is a mass which is having a nodular surface. When you observe very closely, you can see that is not having a smooth surface. You can see there are some nodules. It is typically there is a nodular surface seen on the mass. So there is a visible mass seen in the epigastric region moving with the respiration. The mass is having a nodular surface. You can see there is a nodular surface. You can also see some dilated veins. I hope you can see the dilated veins here in the lower abdomen. You can see the dilated veins in the lower abdomen. You can watch very closely. If I take my finger from below, it is filling from below upwards. You can see this is a vein, dilated vein here. Actually, you should look for dilated veins in standing position. But if you see here in this position, I am doing a test like this. If I'm taking here, it is getting filled. It is getting filled from above downwards as well as from below upwards. There is no filling. It is getting filled from above downwards. There is a vein flow from above downwards. There is some obstruction of the venous veins. Therefore, there is a dilated veins. I will discuss about the vein examination in a future case. In some other case, I will discuss about it. So in this case, you see a nodular surface here. So this is most probably a liver mass. What are the masses you can have in this region? The masses you can have in this region are a stomach mass can be this much big, but it will be extending to up to this place only. Or it can be a pancreatic mass, or it can be a liver mass. So pancreatic mass. Pancreatic mass will not move with respiration. The first point, so that is ruled out. On inspection itself, I can rule out it is not a pancreatic mass. This is mostly a liver mass or a gastric mass. So this is moving with the respiration. So now you have to examine the other areas like left supraclavicular region. If there is any fullness, you have to see here. There is no fullness on inspection. Inspection, there is no fullness here. This is looked to look for any left supraclavicular node. So because I am suspecting this patient can be a malignancy. So now after finishing the inspection completely, I am going now to the palpation. On palpation of the liver, please keep your hand flat in the right iliac fossa like this. So I am keeping my hand in the right iliac fossa with my index finger will be the lateral surface of my index finger will be like this, and I should ask the patient to do take inspiration. So I am slowly going on like this. I am getting the mass here. The mass is striking my lateral part of the index finger here. I can see, I can palpate the mass here. I can palpate the mass boundaries. I can make the boundaries of the mass on all the directions. So I can see he is having mild tenderness also. You can see as I'm pressing, he's having mild tenderness. It's a painful, mild pain is there. So this is the mass boundaries are there. So I'm now palpating on the surface of the mass. It is nodular surface. He's having little pain and it is nodular surface. Typical nodularity is seen. It's a nodular surface. You can note the nodularity. So there is no visible gastric peristalsis. There is no visible gastric peristalsis or visible intestinal peristalsis. This surface is nodular and the mass is hard and the borders are sharp border. Please see, the borders I am palpating. No, it is having a sharp border. This and all you can experience only by palpation. If I palpate, the mass is sharp border is present in the mass. I could see the sharp border of the mass. So I am now palpating for the left supraclavicular node. There is no left supraclavicular node. Left supraclavicular node is palpated in patient sitting position. I should examine from behind for the left supraclavicular node. But this patient is having no supraclavicular nodes. So now let us see what is the liver span in this patient. Now let us see the liver span in this patient. So you have to observe the percussion node here. I should start from mid clavicular line below the second. So resonant. So now the dull note starts. You can see So the dull node starts from here. So the upper border of liver starts from this place. Okay, the upper border of liver starts from this place. I should continue. It's painful. Hold on a minute. So you can see this border is coming from here to here. We have to mark this border. This is a liver, this much enlarged liver. So this much huge enlarged liver can happen only in secondary liver. This can happen only in secondary liver. So secondary liver will have such a long palpable liver, and you can see all the place it is resonant. It is tender. Why that is tender? So the liver is tender. So liver being tender, you should think of the first important reason for the liver being tender is usually secondary liver will be painless. Primary liver will be painful. But here this patient is having minimum pain because of the stretching of the capsule. There are two reasons. Either it is because of the stretching of capsules or due to some hemorrhage within the secondaries. The hemorrhage within the secondaries can have this type of pain. So this patient is having a chances of hemorrhage. I have now evaluated this patient for liver secondaries. So this is a very classical mass. You can see this much huge liver you are seeing in this patient with the multiple nodules all over the surface. Now you can ask a question, sir, can it be a stomach? No, it cannot be a stomach because stomach will not have, we have to on percussion. No, so there is a, I could not percuss much because he is having pain. There will be a resonant node. Please understand this point. There will be a resonant node in this place between the liver and the stomach. There will be a resonant node will be seen. Then the dullness will start here. If there is a stomach huge mass, there will be a resonant node seen followed by a dull node. So, but there is no such findings here. Though, therefore, this patient is having a clear cut case of liver secondary. From my clinical examination, I suspect this is a case of liver secondary, and I'm going to show you what is the finding in the various investigations I have evaluated. So now I'm going to show you the dilated veins here. This is a, you can see on his abdominal wall, there are many dilated veins. All over his abdominal wall, there are dilated veins seen. So now I'm going to show you the direction of flow of these veins. You can see here, I'm going to keep two fingers on the center of the vein, and I'm going to splay it out like this. So I'm going to keep two fingers, I'm going to splay it out, and I will take one by one each finger. If I take the finger above, it is not getting filled. Whereas if I'm going to take the fingers from below, it is getting filled. So this sign, you can see very classically, if I take from the finger above, it is not getting filled. If I'm taking it below, it is getting filled. This sign is known as Harvey sign. This sign shows the flowing of blood from below upwards. So like this, dilated veins on the abdominal wall flowing from below upwards is seen in conditions of IVC obstruction. If there is an IVC obstruction, the blood will flow as a bypass. Instead of going through the deeper veins, they will bypass and run on the abdominal wall. So this is therefore a vein which is running from below upwards because of the IVC getting compressed. So probably this patient having a secondary liver that is compressing the inferior vena cava posteriorly. That is the reason he is having a dilated veins on the superficial abdominal wall. So this is a case of liver secondaries with the suspected IVC obstruction. Okay.
Prep Clinic. Dream Beyond.